The list of frontline workers prioritized for a coronavirus vaccine includes lawmakers on Capitol Hill, and among them, Senator Marco Rubio. Rubio tweeted out a photo of himself getting vaccinated with this encouragement, quote, "I am so confident the COVID-19 vaccine is safe and effective that I decided to take it myself." Setting a good example there, right? Well, Rubio isn't exactly the model of a science-abiding citizen, because let me show you another picture. This is Rubio. This is just on November 11th, speaking before a maskless rally for the Georgia Senate contest. And the rally was such a health risk that our own correspondent, Hyung La, left because she couldn't, you know, didn't want to risk the COVID exposure. Consider that rally and every other anti-science thing that Rubio has done. And our own Ana Navarro says she thinks that means he shouldn't go to the front of the vaccine line. The tweet is this: young, healthy senator who spoke at rallies packed with thousands without masks, who supports Trump, who's downplayed COVID and mocked those who wear masks, is first to go get a vaccine while most medical workers, elderly, and infirm Americans wait. Congratulations on your privilege. And Ana Navarro is with me now. So I take it, you know, the answer to this question of who should get the vaccine first is pretty obvious, and that answer does not include Marco Rubio.
I don't think it should include the senators, period. Particularly, listen, there's something that really gets stuck, I think, in my craw and other people's craw, at the idea that people who have been enabling Donald Trump downplaying the COVID virus, calling it a hoax, who have attended, spoken at, encouraged, promoted, and participated in so many of his reckless rallies where people have been packed like sardines and have spoken at these rallies knowing people are there maskless, who have attended super spreader events at the White House, like we've seen, you know, so many people get infected with COVID at them. And then, after they've been selfish, after they've been reckless, after they've been servile to Donald Trump, then they get to jump the line and go in front of people who are in nursing homes and go in front of people who've been risking their lives for 10 months to keep others safe, like medical workers. They get to go in front of people who are on dialysis and who are on chemo. Give me a damn break. Give me a break. That is just so immoral. And contrast that to Governor Larry Hogan of Maryland, a Republican, mind you, a Republican, who said, "I am not going to be getting this vaccine until the medical workers and the elderly in my state do." That is leadership. That is leadership. And that's what I would hope for, particularly from a senator who's 50 years old and healthy.
Let me read what he tweeted over the weekend. Ana, people are tired of being told they have to stay home and can't work or open their business by people who break their own rules and haven't missed a paycheck. What's your response to that?
Look, I'm really perplexed by the level of privilege that Congress has. Brooke, there's millions and millions and millions of Americans who've lost their jobs. There's millions and millions more who've been furloughed or who've had their salaries cut or who've had their hours cut. Congress has not. They make $174,000 a year. They have not gotten a pay cut. They've not been furloughed. They've not been, their salary has not been lowered 20%. They've got more privileges than most Americans. If they get sick, they get privileged health care. And so, you know, and then it takes them these many months to get together on a stimulus package to give the average American, you know, making under $75,000, $600. That pays for like 4 hours of hush money for Stormy Daniels. You know, that does not pay rent. That does not pay utilities. That does not pay food in a place like Miami, and I suspect New York and most places in the United States. So, you know, I think they've lost touch with the suffering and the pain of their constituents. And let me tell you something about that picture that Marco tweeted out. And it's not just Marco. It's Marco, it's Lindsey Graham, it's so many other people in Congress who are jumping the line. But something that really pissed me off, triggered me, of that post was, you know, he started by making a joke about how he looked away from the needle and how he needed a tan in his arm. You know, you've got privilege that others don't. You are getting a precious vaccine that millions are waiting for. There's people risking their lives on a daily basis that are not getting that vaccine yet. And you crack a joke about your pasty white arm? Really? Really?